Oh. rising of the 20,000, fighting for better working conditions?
Bodies, 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 b On what grounds, Mr. Steuer?
On the ground.
a green horn from the gutter, from the sweatshops and the slums, selling matches for my supper, threading needles for stale crumbs. My brains and gift and cunning, I made the law my trade, gouging clients like a Shylock. Guile and sophistry my blade. I'm the million-dollar lawyer, darling of the powerful and great, of the venal and the crooked, whose sins I vindicate. I can prove an angel guilty, and set the devil free. I cannot wait for justice. All that matters is my fee.
All that matters is
me. Thank you, Mr. Stoyer. Have you in my court?
I object, Your Honor.
On what grounds, Mr. Bostwick?
I object to you presiding as judge. Not long ago, when you had to resign as tenement house commissioner, after 10 children died in a fire, because the skylight of the roof was locked.
Bostwick, rein in your ire.
Nervous Bostwick, what for? I haven't yet even opened fire.
Gentlemen of the jury, we will prove, as the fire raged on the ninth floor, that 146 workers, mostly young women, Jews and Italians, immigrants to this land, suffocated, burned, or jumped to their death. Why? Because the Max Black and Isaac Harris are to blame for all this mess. They knew the door was locked.
Gentlemen of the jury, tragedy, who is to blame?
Who is to blame?
Is it my poor clients?
Your poor clients.
They too fled oppression to better their fate. Arriving penniless, they managed to hire hundreds of workers to fabricate shirt waists.
Fabricate shirt waists.
But lost all in the
fire.
Was it all their fault? Were they alone in their shame?
Whose fault was it? Who is to blame?
Who caused the triangle fire?
Who caused the triangle fire?
The inspectors charged with keeping our buildings sound tucked in the pockets of their protectors instead of responsibly nosing around. So don't shank Harrison Plank.
So don't shank Harrison Plank.
And the city's leaders, those heartless balls. What care they for the starving masses partying with their booze and their malls instead of looking out for the working classes?
Out of masses, out of their masses.
And what about all the lawmen upstate who scorn the workers' sorry plight? Don't let them prevaricate. They fail to do what was right.
It's hard to see this in black and white.
My clients are just pawns of a machine, a scapegoat for the greedy and lax. Their own hands are clean.
So don't dance, I see the mess.
Prosecution calls Mary Bocelli, Ethel Mavic, Katie Wiener, and Sophie Zimmerman.
For weeks, the first dozen shirts on.
ladies, tell us about the doors.
After 10 hours at our wearisome chore, the closing bell finally rings. The door is locked to Washington Place. A watchman stands guard at the Green Street door. He checks our headbands, our personal things. Did we steal a blouse, a button, some lace?
What happened on the night of the fire?
We heard a closing gong and went up to go, singing that sweet song from the Broadway show.
Yeah. We next call William John Shepherd. State your name and trade.
William Gunn Shepherd, reporter for the United Press News Agency.
You were the first newsman on the scene.
Yes.
Tell us what you saw.
I was walking by Washington Square when a puff of smoke caught my eye. When I drew closer, I saw something fall. The first jumper to die. I learned a horrible new sound. Living body hitting the ground.
Thud dead.
Go on.
The ladders didn't reach beyond the sixth floor. The eighth and ninth floors blazed red. The nets couldn't hold the falling bodies.
Thud dead.
Can you go on, Mr. Shepherd?
I must.
What next?
I looked up and saw love amid the flame. A young gent helped a girl to the window. He held her out and let her drop. Then a second and a third came, like helping them into a livery. A terrible death waited in the flame, and his a terrible chivalry. Then came a fourth girl to the sill. She circled him with her arms and kissed him. Then he held her out and let her spill. And then he was on the ledge himself, his coat fluttering up. The air filled his trouser leg, his hat still on his head.
After pouring
On her knees she bent down, her hair is loose, a big soak come. I cannot see. Margaret, I call, Margaret, but she not speak. Ends of hair and trail of dress begin to burn.
And then what happened?
I turn my coat with fur to face, lining on outside.
out last time.
Objection!
What is your objection, Mr. Bostwick?
Mr. Steyer is leading the witness.
Overruled. Do you have any more questions, Mr. Steyer?
Let's go over your story again, Miss Alterman, to make sure you haven't left anything out. You saw Margaret on her knees.
Down on knees, hair is loose.
The ends of her hair.
And trail of dress.
The trail of her dress began.
Became a successful businessman.
Why?
sits.
Hoops and bustles,
but such is not our passion. We toss the modern shirt waists at present all the rage. Ideal for work and leisure, a wonder of the age. Costume of the Gibson girl,
our Helen of Troy,
suitable for promenade or lunch at the Savoy. Democratic, acrobatic, Yankee to the core. Charismatic, bureaucratic, sheep for peace or war. From temperance hall to factory, for every social rank, the shirt laces all world and kind, and doesn't break the bank.
Noble sentiments.
Please move it along, Mr. Steuer.
Certainly, Your Honor. Mr. Harris, is this the lock from the Washington Place door on the ninth floor of your factory?
Yes, it is.
And you tell the jury whether this was locked at the time of the fire on March 25th.
Objection! Mr. Blank is not a locksmith.
I will bring in my experts later. All I want is for Mr. Harris and Mr. Blank to tell us whether the door was locked at the time of the fire.
I can tell that just by looking at the lock.
Of course you can't. And neither can anyone else. The fire tense would have felt in this lock beyond recognition. But we can see that this lock is hardly damaged at all. Still works perfectly fine. No way to prove whether it was locked or not. Right. Your witnesses, Mr. Bostwick.
Do you customarily lock all but one door on the ninth floor?
Customarily, but I don't check the locks every day.
Why do you feel it necessary to lock the other doors?
If we don't inspect the workers' bags, they'll steal us blind.
I see. They're all thieves, your workers.
Not all, but many are.
How much did they steal from you the year prior to the fire?
Mr. Stoyer, are you ready to present your closing argument?
I am, Your Honor. You, the jury, must now pass judgment on my clients. Did the people prove beyond a reasonable doubt that Margaret Schwartz died because the door was locked?
Has it been proved beyond a reasonable doubt?
Remember, it doesn't matter if they were remiss, just whether their error resulted in this.
jury. You must now render your verdict. What caused the death of Margaret Schwartz? Was it the locked door on the ninth floor? Satisfied not merely that the door was locked, but that the defendants knew it was locked at the time of the fire. You may find the defendants guilty of manslaughter.
Thank you. rewriting New York State's labor laws and creating a state department of labor to enforce them.
Under New York Governor Franklin D. Roosevelt, Francis Perkins, and Robert Wagner, who chaired the commission, created the nation's most sweeping worker protections through the Good Deal, including the National Labor Relations Act.
So you see, the arc of the moral universe does bend toward justice.
Like my great grandfather, William God Shepherd, I am a journalist, Sarah Shepherd Ashton, and a storyteller. For the story does not end in Judge Crane's courtroom. Yes, it's true. It was the deadliest.